So now, dear students, 13.1, first question. A plastic box 1.5 meter long, 1.25 meter wide and 65 centimeter deep is to be made. Means a box like this is to be made. Now the point to be note down is, it is opened at the top. Dear students, means this box contains 5 walls, 4 surrounding walls and the base. It is opened from the top means we are not going to take the top part. Means 5 walls are involved. Ignoring the thickness of the plastic sheet, determine the area of the sheet required for making the box. So yesterday, while giving you the formulas, I have given you a formula for area of 5 wall. Area of 5 wall, what was that area? I told you in 5 wall area we'll take 4 wall area. Area of 4 wall, right, plus area of base, area of base, like this. So what is area of 4 wall? 4h into l plus b, right, plus l into b is the base, because base is rectangular. All the parts of the box are rectangular. I told you yesterday how to derive the formula. So in this way, just what you have to do now is put the values given the in the question, the dimensions in the formula, and get the area of wall. Now while writing the statement area of 5 wall, instead of this we will write the statement the area of the sheet required for making the box, right? We have to keep this statement in our mind, because the sheet is required only for 5 walls. So we'll write in this way, but while writing it in the question, we'll write the sheet required for making the box. So we'll write the sheet required for making the box is equal to area of 4 wall, means 4 walls of the box, plus area of base. So here 4 is not there, it is 2. 2h into l plus b plus l into b. So just put the values, put the dimensions. Before putting the dimensions, you must be very careful that all the units must be same. Here you can see the two dimensions are given in meters and the height is given to us in centimeters. So we will first convert this height into meters by dividing it by 100, and from there we'll get 0.65 meters. So this is very important to remember. Now just put the values, like 2 into h, h is 0.65, into l plus b, l plus b means 1.5 plus 1.25, then plus l into b. What is l? It is 1.5 into what is b? It is 1.25 meters. Now dear students, solve it and you will get the area or the sheet required for making the box. So let us calculate it. So dear students, by solving this we will get the area 5.45 meters square. That much sheet is required to make that much big box. And while calculating, do not forget the property board mass. Board mass means bracket should be solved first. First of all, solve the bracket, add them, then do the multiplication, because before addition multiplication is there. Addition means bracket, then multiplication, and here is the multiplication, then add the two things and you'll get this area. Now in the question, dear students, what is the second part of this question? Find the cost of the sheet for it. If a sheet measuring 1 meter square cost rupees 20, means if the cost of 1 meter square sheet is rupees 20, what would be the cost of that much meter square? So we'll take cost of 1 meter square sheet is rupees 20, therefore cost of 5.45 meter square sheet is equal to, we'll multiply it and we'll get the answer. So how much rupees we have to spend? We have to spend 109 rupees to make this box in purchasing the sheet. So dear students, in this way you can calculate. Now dear students, let us read the second question and see what we have to do. The length, breadth and height of a room are 5 meter, 4 meter and 3 meter, means all the three dimensions of a room are given to us respectively. Find the cost of whitewashing the walls of the room. How many walls are there in a room? Can you tell me? Yes, there are 4 walls and a ceiling. Ceiling means on which we hang the fans. This is known as ceiling, right? So means we have to whitewash the 4 walls of the room plus 1 ceiling. Means again, how many walls are required to paint, to whitewash? We need to find out the area of 5 wall, because 4 walls plus 1 ceiling, 5 walls. Find the cost of whitewashing the walls of the room and ceiling at the rate of ₹750 per meter square. Dear students, the question is just similar to first question. Again, in this question you have to find out the area of 5 wall, means the same formula we will apply, and again the cost for 1 meter square is given to you, and by multiplying the total area to be whitewashed by this cost, we'll get the total cost required for whitewashing. So try this question yourself. This is your homework. Now third question. The floor of a rectangular hall has a perimeter 250 meter. Dear students, let us note down the things. Again, the hall is in rectangular form. So hall is in rectangular form like this. This is the hall. This is length, this is breadth and this is height of the wall, right? So now what they are telling us, its perimeter. The floor of a rectangular hall. Dear students, floor means जो नीचे वाला हिस्सा होता है, वो किसी भी रूम का जो नीचे वाला हिस्सा होता है वो किस शेप का होता है? रेक्टेंगुलर शेप का. रेक्टेंगुलर मीन्स एल और बी, राइट? नीचे जो बेस है, बेस और सीलिंग सिमिलर होते हैं, तो इसका हमें पैरीमीटर गिवन है. व्हाट इज़ द पैरीमीटर ऑफ दिस बेस? द पैरीमीटर ऑफ दिस बेस इज 250 meters, राइट? सो नाउ नेक्स्ट, इफ द कॉस्ट ऑफ पेंटिंग द 4 वॉल्स at the rate of this is this, find the height of the hall. So dear students, first of all, always start the question from the things which are given to you. Like in this question, perimeter is given to us. We will start doing the question from here. Perimeter means, perimeter of rectangle means, what do you mean? What is the perimeter? 2 into L plus B. This is the perimeter, 250. So from here we can calculate L plus B is equal to 250 by 2, that is 125 meter. This is L plus B. यहाँ पर हमें ये मिल जाता है. Now total cost of whitewashing is given to us. It is ₹15,000. So let us write down this thing also. First thing given to us is perimeter. From there we got L plus B. Now total cost is given to us. Total cost of painting is equal to, what is total cost? It is ₹15,000, right? So dear students, total cost हमें कैसे मिलती है? For example, if I'll tell you that you have to purchase 5 chocolates, ठीक है, 5 chocolates, and the cost of 1 chocolate is ₹20, तो 5 chocolates कितने की आएंगी? टोटल कॉस्ट 5 चॉकलेट्स की कैसे निकलेगी? 5 चॉकलेट्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाई 20, यू विल गेट द टोटल कॉस्ट. मीन्स मल्टीप्लाई करने से मिलती है हमें टोटल कॉस्ट, राइट? सो विल डू द सेम थिंग. टोटल कॉस्ट पेंटिंग की दे रखी है. पेंट हमने कैसे किया है? हमें पेंट करने के लिए क्या बोला गया है? द फ्लोर ऑफ अ रेक्टेंगुलर हॉल इज दिस. द कॉस्ट ऑफ पेंटिंग द 4 वॉल्स ऑफ द रेट, दिस इज गिवन टू अस. तो कॉस्ट ऑफ पेंटिंग 4 वॉल्स इज गिवन टू अस. सो कॉस्ट का, वॉल्स का फॉर्मूला क्या आएगा? 4 वॉल्स का. टोटल कॉस्ट कैसे निकलेगी? एरिया ऑफ 4 वॉल, राइट, इनटू कॉस्ट ऑफ पेंटिंग 1 meter square इज ₹10 पर मीटर स्केयर. from in this way we'll get the total cost. So now what is the formula for area 4 wall? It is 2h into l plus b, put the formula, into 10 is equal to 15,000. So dear students, just solve it. 2h, from the first part we have l plus b, it is 125 meter, so we'll put this value 125 from there, okay, is equal to 1500. ये हमने cancel कर दिया direct multiplication में. So now by cross multiplying we'll take 2 and 125 to other side. H is equal to 1500 divided by 2 into 125. 125 2s are 150 and 10. So what is the height of the hall? Height is 10 meters. So answer is, height of the hall is 10 meters. So I hope it is clear to you. First of all, always start the question from the given things. Perimeter of base is given to you. Base ke shape ka rectangular. Rectangle ka perimeter ka formula lagayenge. After that, second given thing is total cost. टोटल कॉस्ट बेटा कैसे निकलती है? मल्टीप्लीकेशन से. किसको मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे? जिसकी ये टोटल कॉस्ट है. दे हैव गिवन द टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ पेंटिंग फोर वॉल्स, सो वी हैव अप्लाइड द एरिया फोर वॉल इनटू 1 मीटर स्क्वायर की कॉस्ट है 10. सो बाय सॉल्विंग इट यू विल गेट द आंसर इन दिस वे.